It does give me great pleasure to introduce our guest speaker this evening. Cameron Kerr is the Director and Chief Executive of Taronga Conservation Society Australia, which operates Taronga Zoo, which is the greatest zoo in the world. Taronga Western Plains Zoo, I haven't been, but I should. Dubbo, Taronga Wildlife Hospitals, and Taronga Training Institute, which I haven't been to, but I'll put on my list. Prior to joining Taronga Zoo in 2009, Cameron was a research and development scientist for Bayer Pharmaceuticals and marketing manager for Wella Australia and Faulding Health Consumer Division. We're very proud to claim Cameron as one of our own alumni. He holds a Bachelor of Science, graduating with honours from UNSW, and a Master of Commerce in Organisational Behaviour and Marketing from UNSW Business School, graduating in 1991. Please thank Cameron for giving up his time to be here this evening and welcome him. Thank you, Cameron.
Well, thank you, Chris. And I must say it's an honour to be amongst all these bright minds and people that are really excited about their career. I'd also like to pay my acknowledgements to the traditional owners of this land. You know, we sit here today on this flat land, was grassland once, and the local Indigenous people here talked about how they lived more effectively, how did they solve the problems, whether it was a drought or flood, when learning and reading the environment around them. In fact, Indigenous culture in Australia is the longest continuous culture on earth. So there's a few things that we can learn from the past. We can learn from people like Chris and alumni that have been before. Not saying that I'll have those pearls of wisdom, but it's certainly an important part of University of New South Wales. It's about learning from each other. So they've said I should talk for about 10 minutes. I'll make sure I stick to that, and please start throwing things at me if I don't. Just to give you a little bit of an insight as to my career, because you never really know where it's going to go. If someone said to me when I was 22, Cameron, when you're in your 40s, you're going to be working at Taronga Zoo in Sydney, I would have said, not a hope in hell. There's no way that that's going to be the case. So I started out with a science degree here, and the buildings and facilities are a little different to they are now. I can say there's been some great improvements over the time. But the thing about University of New South Wales is it has always prided itself on having really good lecturers and really applying that knowledge, as Chris said. So in your program, I had to do a great deal of field work. That was part of me getting that degree. And of course, that took up all my university holidays, and I thought it was such a pain. And I can't tell you how important that is right till today. All that work I had to do, most of it for free, I wasn't getting paid, so it wasn't easy, you know, doing night jobs on weekends while I was studying. But how important that is for the rest of your life. So today, I'll talk a little bit about my career, and then I'm going to talk about what I see as valuable as employees when you graduate from here. And it may not be what you first came here to think it would be. Started out in a science degree, finished that, worked in laboratories, worked in research for a number of years, and then realised actually that I found I enjoyed communicating the discoveries that we were making at that time, and it was a great time. We were making lots of discoveries. It was in the agricultural industry. And communicating those and sharing that knowledge with the agricultural community. So I went back and did a Master of Commerce here. And did that at night time, worked during the week, and spent most of my weekends looking out the window in a flat in Cronulla as all the people walked down to the beach while I was studying. So I reckon a few of you could relate to that one and will relate to it over the next few years. My career took me interesting paths. I went from being a scientist to working in consumer hair care. Now, I'd done agricultural science, I'd worked with farmers and vets and travelled around the bush of Australia and worked in labs. I can tell you I was the worst qualified person out there to be talking about the fashion industry and marketing the fashion industry. But I personally wanted to challenge myself. I'd done a marketing degree here and I had a technical advantage marketing products in the science industry, and I wanted to test myself. So I threw myself into an industry where I had no background knowledge, no skills. And I can say, for the first 6 months, the water was here. I didn't have the skills that were inherent, the tacit skills of that industry. But what I had picked up in my 2 degrees and in a bit of time working in other industries is an ability to learn and research and understand the value of that and read situations and be able to get along with people from all walks of life. I needed to get along with the CEO because I was a product manager in the marketing team. I needed to do presentations to him to get my products to market. But I also, just as important to my career, was the guy on the packaging line who designed the cardboard box that if it wasn't the perfect shape, didn't fit on the pallet, Woolworths wouldn't accept it. And if I failed at any of those points along the way, I didn't have a job, and they'd taken a risk having a guy come from outside the industry. Now, that knowledge came from dealing with all sorts of different people in my time, through my 2 degrees at universities, and of course, in the workplace. No one in any degree taught me those skills, but they gave me the opportunity to learn and understand how to work with other people. So I think in your time here in your degree, you are more fortunate than I was because we've got an incredible diversity of culture here, in this room here. Right around the world we've represented. And if I can say the most important thing you can do over the next 3 years is when you walk out of here this afternoon, don't stay with the person that you're sitting next to now who makes you feel comfortable. Go and talk to randoms. That's what you guys call them, isn't it? Strangers in my language, right? Go and talk to people that you don't know because you don't know how valuable that is at two levels. I promise you in business, you will bump into them around down the track. But also, you'll be learning to deal with other people. In September last year, I was solving problems and working with governments and local people in the Republic of Congo. A month later, I was at a UN Congress dealing with people from around the world on illegal wildlife trafficking. Some of the smartest people in the world were at that UN Congress. 3 weeks before, I was working with people that believe in black magic and have had no schooling in their entire life. And in my job, the work that we do in the Republic of Congo with people who have had no education in their entire life is just as important as the people that I was dealing with, the president of the UN CITES mission. So you can see how important getting along with people is in any job that you're doing. Just quickly, I'll give you a few tips. How many minutes to go? Just give us a sense of it. One or two? All right. Use the resources. You've gone to a university that is called a GO8. Now, I don't expect you to know what that means. It's really important to Chris and a few others around here. You don't have to worry about that, right? That is one of the great universities of Australia, one of the top eight. Now, what the top eight universities do in Australia is they have very experienced, very high quality lecturers who continually stay in touch with the market and research and provide ways of thinking and challenges for you to solve your own problems. It's not about giving you the best technical information so you take that way in your head, because I can tell you that's going to be out of date in 2 years. What they will be doing is talking to you about complex systems thinking and the issues that are emerging and giving you the skills to think through those complex issues and guide you. And guess what? You're not going to be doing it on your own. When I was an undergrad, I loved doing assignments on my own. I was in control of my own destiny, just like school. When you're doing your postgrad work, most of your work will be working in groups or going out and doing research on your own. That is much harder, but guess what? That is what the real world's like. I can't think of a single day that any employee in my organisation, and there's 1,200 of them across the two zoos and around the world, I can't think of a single one of them that can do their job well on their own. Every single one of them has to garner support, and they don't have the authority to tell these people what to do, just like you when you're doing a group assignment. You've got to garner support, come to ways of working to solve those problems and get through and meet deadlines. So working with people in group assignments here is really important. I also don't need people in my organisation that need to be told where to find resources. I like people that say, I can see someone over there, or I know there's a resource online. I'm going to read that, and that'll tell me where to find other information. So in your coursework here, this week particularly, you'll be offered lots of opportunities in a GO8 university like this on how to use researching skills. There'll be classes in researching. There'll be all sorts of programs on tips for new students at this campus on how to do well at this campus. Now, Chris and the team here have seen tens of thousands of students go through. So I reckon they've got a sense on what skills you guys need that, sure, you might get by without it, but it might save you 12 hours a month just because you went to a course for 1 hour in a week instead of having ice cream on a donut. You can have ice cream on a donut after the course is finished, right? So those are some of the things that I would strongly recommend. You're going to a great university, make use of the resources. Some of the other universities out there don't even offer those resources. Careers advice, I think I've already said it. I've had the most unlinear career in my life. Please don't come out of here and think that you'll go from one job up the chain like that. Take risks, move sideways. I took a step back at one point, that was a bit risky. I took a step sideways in another job, and they were the best things I did because I changed industries, I got to see the way different parts of organisations worked, and it set me up to get a CEO job. And of course, there's not a lot of those around. So I was very, very fortunate. And again, by coming here, use those opportunities to do courses and mix with people and take risks, take social risks today, this afternoon when you leave here. The other thing is, and I touched on this, is the importance of keeping in contact with your networks. I spend my life networking, and I can't tell you, every time I am at something and I think, oh, do I really need to be at it? It turns out to be the best thing that I did. Last night, I was at a function. I really wasn't looking forward to it. I sat down next to Philip Lowe, an alumni. We had a good chat about where the economy is going. There are a few tips in there for me that there's no way he'd be allowed to say in front of the media. But one-on-one, you can have a chat and get a few insights. I was sitting right behind the minister, Federal Minister for Innovation and Science. Guess what? I'm about to put a proposal out to create the Taronga Institute of Science and Learning. So that's a good person for me to bump into at that function. These are the sorts of networks, the people in this room, you will be working in global organisations. Some of you will go home to your own countries, others will go and work in other countries. And I can bet you that 6 degrees of separation in business is actually only about 3 degrees. Okay, I'm sure I've gone over time. Thank you very much for listening. Have a great time in your degree.